All right, and we should be live. Just tweet out really quick that we are going live and that we're going to be playing more Nioh tonight. And hopefully my desktop audio was muted. It looks like it was. You probably did not hear the stream echoing there. Great. Now we're going to do a real quick run of Warrior of the West in the hopes that A, we get his sword, and B, just to kind of warm up. Roll away and recast Sloth Talisman. There we go. Both of us are incredibly slow right now. Oh. Man, that... I did not realize how much I was relying on the quick recovery from being out of key until now that I'm out of it. Stop. Fucking stop that. Wow, he's got a lot of invincibility frames. Or not invincibility, but super armor, I guess. Yeah, nothing. That's fine. Well played. Yeah, let's leave. We have a lot of missions left to do, guy, and not a ton of time to do them in. So let me make sure. Alright. So we were in Zone 5, at the very end of Zone 5, and we're going to be moving on to Zone 6. And then maybe 7? It looks like there's room for a Zone 7, but that might just be like maybe New Game Plus sort of thing. Select when you want to go there, for sure. But who knows, we might finish up Nioh tonight and be able to start Nioh in the near future. You know, I wasn't even paying attention to what our mission here was. I'm just gonna keep going towards the marker until we finish up whatever's going on. Also, one thing that I was looking at is that while I do like the bonus luck from Spider Boy, I do get bonuses from using the Raiken. From my set. So, like, if you look at, say, like, oh, shoot, I just not equipped my weapon. Is this the one? Yeah, this is the weapon. I should lock that. If you look at my weapon, and then you look at the set bonus, I get increased attack and defense when I'm using this thing, and also a huge, like, 30% bonus to close combat damage if they're electrified, which means I'm probably going to look into making a lightning sword, since I do have to have my sword equipped to get that bonus. But like, if I can get them afflicted with water, say it's like a boss or a large enemy, if I can afflict them with water, switch to lightning, afflict them with lightning, and then switch back to my good sword, I'll be doing a lot, is what I'm getting at. Who just saw me? Oh, you. Okay. And you're using Hamaya arrow. No, that, never mind, that's just a gun. Luckily, my new bow, pretty excellent, which is saying something, because my last bow, well, the bow before this wasn't part of the set, and then the Warrior of the West bow I had before this one was very low level. Hello. What are you doing? Alternatively, I don't know if I'm going to make a lightning sword, since using Raikin will just immediately get me up to electrifying my opponents anyway, since it seems like they're quite good at that. But, I mean, it's an idea for something I can do with the set. If I can ever find another lightning sword as good as this one, I'll probably equip this and then keep the other sword being used at all times, because, yeah, that'd be way better. Really? Fucking thing. Also, because it was necessary, I did look at my abilities and discovered that Tiger Sprint gets a 30% damage bonus from this set. So I unlocked and switched to Tiger Sprint as the ability I'm using here. I'm still getting used to it, but I have a feeling it'll be pretty good once we get it all up and running. And as with last time, I am trying to use my Guardian Spirit more often. I had this weird, like, hesitance to use it when I first started playing the game and for basically the entire first five areas. Uh-oh. I think they just called friends. Yeah. Yeah, so those are the basic changes I've made to how we play the game. Just before stream, actually. So I haven't had a ton of time to kind of check them out and see what's going on there. But I'm also going to start fighting more Revenants again in the hopes that some of them have better gear than what I'm using now. Trying to land perfect guards, though, still pretty hard. Knowing when their guard breaks, less hard. Shinobi apparel. Okay, so that wasn't what I was looking for at all. I'm looking for people with the same gear set as me. So, sword wielders are the big one. If they have Raikin equipped, that's also a pretty big tell. So, when I get to, like, endgame, if I'm trying to farm these guys, I can probably look for anyone with Raikin equipped and with a sword and tell, like, oh, they probably have the Warrior of the West set. She's going to be real good when I'm trying to get better gear from people who have been gearing up much longer than I am. Oh, that's right, I also have Yadagarasu as an available... I should check what he does. As a guardian spirit, because I have no idea so far. How is this NPC spirit giving me more trouble than anyone else I've faced so far? I guess it's because the guard timing for spears is a little bit weird. They have these, like, super fast hits, but also some ones that have even weirder timing, where they kind of, like, swing around a while before they hit. Also, hopefully I sound a little bit better on the mic. I've been previously using my second monitor for, all my PS4 stuff. Just everything attached to PS4, attached to Wii U, anything like that. I have managed to stretch the cables out a bit further than they were before. To get it on my primary monitor, which is also the one right in front of my mic. So hopefully I can just look forward and do that, but I do have to look to the side to look at chat now, so I'm not constantly turning my head just to look at the game. Which, let's face it, probably better for me. Okay, so these blue spots are treasure. I do have treasure sense again. I didn't realize that. I think that's from the dogs, from the good pups. And I still have Kodama and enemy sense, but no Kodamas in this area, so we're fine. There's a shrine in here. Oh, the objective must be underground, because that that entrance to the underground area at the very beginning of the level was just completely closed. So must have been forcing me to climb up to eventually, ladders are for nerds, to eventually go back down here. I just gotta fight my way through, nice and easy. That poor guy. A lot of people here crushed to death. Oh, that doesn't sound good. But, all legendary gear and with two Raikin. So I have a oh no wait, he's using a lightning sword. That's not the sword from this set at all. A red demon armor. Entirely different. Oh, he has real quick recovery from being out of stamina on him. Yeah, like, I can't even land the hit in time. It takes too long to wind up to start getting that hit for me to actually get it on him. That's really nice, actually. I probably want that. Oh, he has the spider! Uh-oh. Yep. There it is. That's what I was thinking. I was guarding, though, because I took no damage. Oh, he dropped all of his red demon armor from that. That's pretty nice. Yeah, everyone got crushed to death right here, which I probably should have thought of when I was pushing forward with my incredibly potent dog advance. Also, I'm trying to not hold guard 100% of the time. In between guarding his attacks, so I can still build up a little bit of stamina back. You know, that old chestnut. That old classic. The good strat. Sorry, I got nothing else. I'm just finding a couple of revenants. I don't have a lot of text for this. I'm just trying to, hopefully, eventually, upgrade my gear with someone who's wearing the same shit. But I'll have to find someone wearing the same shit for that to even hope to apply. It seems like a lot of people are wearing the red demon armor right now. Yeah, I see you there. Come on. I really hate these statues, the gyroid looking. I mean, they do look like gyroids, right? These are what gyroids are based off of, is whatever these statues are. Cut down by sentry. Yeah, I see him. Yep. There's another guy there too, right? In addition to the sentry. I mean, there should be. It sounded like somebody else noticed me. Right? Holy shit. Wow, okay, I can take sentries pretty easily now. Oh, that's why he's a gunman. A cannoneer, no less. But a cannoneer, right, guarding a free soul stone, so I guess it works. He loves that spin move. It's a bit tricky to tell when their guard is going to run out, just because it seems like the first couple hits of my combo, like, don't take away stamina. Like, my first one or two blocks never seem to take away a lot of stamina, and then, like, the third block takes away a little chunk of it. Or if they just don't block, that works too, I guess. Wow, he took very little damage. Got very heavy armor, I guess. Yeah, like that. It seemed like my first hit of my combo took away his stamina for guarding there. I'm still not quite sure what determines that that will happen. Eh, doesn't really matter. We're the East set. Ah, my opponent. My natural rival. Due to geographic differences. Okay, and he's using Phoenix. Which I wonder if Phoenix... I wonder if Guardian Spirits can apply on these dead enemies. I actually have never seen one use one. But then, Guardian Spirits seem mostly to be the main player thing for while you're doing world exploration sort of stuff. I can't say that I've ever been in a situation where I was like, ah, that enemy's using a guardian spirit, except for just the huge boss fights. And if random enemies, even if they were random, like, player enemies, had that, it would just feel a bit weird? I don't know. Oh, also, to whoever said last time, I don't think it's applying poison or paralysis debuff because you already have water, and maybe you can only have one? After playing a bit more, I'm pretty sure that person was right, so whoever you are, if you're still watching, sorry about that. Yeah, you had it. That seems to be what it was, because the moment I switched to a non-elemental sword to try something, it seemed like I got that spider buff back. And that even happened during last stream, so... I didn't mention it at the time because I was very tired, but watching over it afterwards, yeah, that was definitely what was going on. One thing I'm kind of interested in is seeing if there is a Guardian Spirit that has more than a 20% defense buff. I'm kind of assuming that they won't, and then that defense buff kind of exists to... make things more difficult while you're crawling your way back to your Amrita. But at the same time, like, maybe there is a Guardian Spirit who's just very good at what it does that has, like, 25 or 30% damage reduction, which, I mean, unless it also had good abilities to work with that, it wouldn't really be stellar, but it'd be cool. A nice little flavor thing if one of them is just better at defense. What is up with this red demon armor that everyone is using it? What is the set bonus? Damage reduction, skill damage on spearfall, which nobody's using a spear. Well, I guess they are. Close combat damage plus 10. Increase attack and defense for using a certain spirit, Enko. Close combat damage, enemy scorch, so if they're on fire, you deal more. and then 25% key recovery speed, which is probably the big reason. Extra stamina is always welcome in an action exploration game like this one. Just stab him. Thank you. Having some severe trouble with that there. Oh, you got the gyroids in this hallway. Yeah, I don't trust that at all. I mean, most of my enemies seem to die before the elemental effects really kind of take place. So I'm not too worried about all of it. There you are. With, like, the lightning bonus that I'm kind of thinking of and all that jazz, but it still seems like something I should pay attention to kind of maximize what I'm getting out of my Guardian Spirits and my gear set, considering I have been using this gear set for a while and not really optimizing it. And it's been doing fine for me, but I mean, I should try to get any advantage I can, right? Most of this is rhetorical, by the way. Don't worry if you're not actually thinking about answering, because that's kind of a general idea. I don't really expect anyone to answer when I'm just crawling through a random side quest like this. I don't trust this at all. Will roaring gun ammo go through helmets? Oh yeah, it will. Okay. Why would the ruins have a key to a door? Okay, so this guy's using the lightning axe. Which is huge, by the way, and it looks like it's made out of a rib cage. Like, literally a rib cage. Also, I don't know why I didn't have Tiger Sprint equipped from the start. I really like EI, and it's just EI, but with movement attached, which seems like something I would really enjoy. And so far it has been. Hi? Are there guards for you? Oh, you just got kidnapped, and I'm here to rescue. All right. I can dig it. What's this treasure, though? Sayo Arashi. That anything special, or... Oh, I also got this axe that people are using. What part of it? It's part of the Kaido Maru set. Skill damage, Rumbling Earth. Something battle focus. Skill effect extend. Increased attack and defense for an axe. Okay, so it's just an axe set. Slew Shuten Doji. A name I know, again, for reasons. I'm not quite sure where I've heard most of these demon names before. They just kind of wheedle their way into popular culture. Is wheedle the right word there, even? Let me check. No, it's not the right word. They just kind of sneak into popular culture. Yeah, Weedle is like trying to, hey buddy, come on, come on, just let me in, buddy, come on, don't be like that, just let me in. That sort of thing. He cut off his hair for me. Must have been the daughter of an extremely well-known personage. I mean, she said her dad was known as a demon. So I wonder who the dad is supposed to be. If it's obvious, someone please tell me. I don't much like missing obvious stuff, but I'm really not one for this sort of thing. We have tons of hair that I haven't used. That's a sentence I just said with my mouth. Okay. Alright, and I'll get the last key bonus here in a minute. Meanwhile, I could upgrade my sloth talismans again. Or... I've already got all the elixir stuff, right? Yeah. Increases duration to sacred water, I could build towards that. Makes it easier to find rare items. I could actually bring that to any kind of gear I'm farming. So that sounds pretty good. And also I have titles too. I have a lot of titles. Wow, okay. Ninjutsu power, item drop rate, gold earned. And lower received elemental attack damage, increase EXP, increase versus Yokai Realm. I don't know. And then luck is my next one, so nice, nice. Let's level up and then we'll move to the next area. We are still doing our quest to get everything to level 15, at least. So I can actually equip gear.
ゆわさごすけ大義であった。家康殿、小早川秀秋でござりまする。逃げた三成めは沢山の城へと落ち延びる算段でありましょう。
三成の首はぜひ私めにお任せを。この秀明、霧に苦しめられましたが、東軍へと馳せ参じ、死死奮陣の活躍。好きに致せ。小早川殿だけでは難儀であろう。わしも手はずを整えたら、すぐに後を追いまする。キャリーはいる。I'm going to.
ナオマサ殿と小早川殿は逃れる石田勢を追って沢山の城へと軍を進めた。じゃがわしらの探るところ、三成殿はケリーメと共に伊吹山へと落ちたようだ。ウィリアム、お主は天海殿と共に伊吹山へ向かえ。敗軍の将とはいえ三成殿は油断ならぬ男。
As evidenced by the whole, you know, giant demon skeleton that he was willing to summon to try to save one of his most loyal retainers. That, how's that guy doing, by the way? Did he get killed in the demon skeleton ambush? It feels like that would be a thing that would happen. Oh, there are different Twilight missions. I probably can't take that one on yet, but I am only 25 Kodama away from all of them. So, I feel like this is the last area with Kodama at the very least, or maybe the last area of the game. Oh, and there's literally one right at the start. Very tricky. Putting him behind the start point like this. Thank goodness for Kodama Sense in the first area. Oh, is there anything else back here, or just the area where we supposedly came from? Okay. Let me set... Can I set an Oracle Blessing for the first area already? So I just keep that. Or do I have to find at least one of them to get the blessing? Yeah, I cannot get the blessing. So we'll equip Healer Blessing for now, increase our elixir drop rate, and then when we find a shrine after rescuing one of the Oracle Kodama, we'll switch to that and just stick with it. What? Whoa. What is going on here? Let me poke a hole in his dome. You have an enemy symbol on you, so I'm assuming... Oh no, you're also hostile. Okay. It's all of you. Everyone in this room is hostile to me. I could have just waited for y'all to finish the fight with each other, but whatever. Thought I was saving you. Oh no. Wait, so who... Hold on. Which armies are these, if there are people who are aggressing the guy we're chasing and his army? Because there are currently, like, two factions that I'm aware of. There's... the faction that I'm on, led by the Tanuki, who is sick, I think, if I'm remembering that right. And then there is the guy who unleashed the demon skeleton, Kelly unleashed the demon skeleton, like, quotation marks, for that guy. Given the theming, either Ishida and Tokugawa, or Akechi and Nobunaga. What happened to your leg, guy? Slow God 666, not doing so hot at the moment. I don't know what gear it is on this gear set that apparently lets people get up faster, or maybe everybody's just getting real lucky with it, but it seems like a lot of this gear has that same, Whoa! Okay, so that's a mine. I was wondering what that was. Has that, quick recovery from, being out of key buff. Okay, and that's the area with the two yokai that I was kind of hesitating on going in a minute ago. So that is... If that's a shortcut, that means I should probably... Oh, hello. I should probably go clear that out here before I go any further. I have my dogs up. It should be fine. Seems like using those abilities is also much better in a group of enemies, since it does have a bonus for if you get Emrita back while you're doing that. And oh, that's another thing I have to kick down, so it's a second shortcut. You have the same gear that I do. No, you got a different gear set. That's a different helmet. Oh, there, you really like how it looks. And you glamored it that way. It's one of the two. I'm figuring it's probably not glamour, though. No, I'm thinking with my own Mio, it might be worth it to look into, yeah, lightning talismans, since if I don't have my dogs up, I'll still be able to get the lightning bonus from using that one. God, I'm trying to think about the factions in this game, and one of the things that kills me is that I am terrible, in general, with names. So I've probably met all of these characters at least once or twice, but apart from kind of the main few, I always have trouble thinking of which one is which in terms of my allies. Whoa. Yeah, I already came from this way, right? Why is it so goddamn smoky? Is it this hazy out here, too? Yeah, it ain't much better. I mean, all the torches, I guess, but that doesn't really seem right. You have a helmet, enjoy the roaring gun ammo. And still no more Kodama, but I haven't gone that far yet. That was my set. Okay. That was better than what I have, I guarantee it. What is on this piece? Running speed and evasion key usage. And dash key usage when critical. Okay, but that's when critical. That's actually way worse than mine, though. It's way lower level. It's like level 62. Which means his other stuff, also probably not ideal. Yeah, all of these are lower level than some of mine. I guess because I just made mine? It makes sense. I mean, even if they are like, legendary, that's just... I mean, I can uncraft them. I can break them. Disassemble is the word I was looking for there unsuccessfully. I can unmake them. Not really the word I was looking for. Alright, treasure sense and Kodama sense and enemy finder all picking up nothing there. So, alright. I got a couple of small dudes. Gotta see if I can try to get them out of this area without aggroing the big yokai that's making that big gas cloud. Hey, you too, huh, guy? We're just both playing that little dodge game. Not gonna bother Space Jam there quite yet. Okay, now I see a Kodama on the map, but he's probably up there. Prey, huh? Alright, whatever. Also, we got bats nearby. I gotta be careful near any caves up on those ledges. What? Why is there just a hole here? That's not even a demon wall or anything. It's just a hole. I can hear something groaning from back here. Why do you have such a big red enemy circle? Why are you so big and glowy on my map, guy? Oh shit, he summons a revenant immediately? Oh my god, that's really cool. Cut down by William. Yeah. Let's kill his ghost, too. Kill this man so hard, not even his ghost comes back. Has that been happening for anyone with a big circle? Pulling Ochoco or what, something like that, whatever it is. What is that? Is that a weapon? Summon a visitor. Oh, okay. I have like 100 of them. And I keep finding more. And I'm just never using them. I'm guessing that's like the, that's the multiplayer thing, right? Like, that's the offering you use to play in multiplayer? Or summon, like, an NPC guest? There's a Kodama up on that. Not up on there, just in there. Okay. Here, little guy. That was a big bat-infested cave. I almost forgot about the bats for a second. That would not have been excellent. Excuse me, just gonna get knocked to my doom by a couple of fucking bats. The most embarrassing way to go. Okay, another shrine. I've only found like one other Kodama, so I don't even know if it's worth it yet. Or if I just want to keep exploring. Let's go take care of this guy. Just real quick. Wow, that was generous. I was entirely expecting to miss there. That's right, I don't have Amrita sense, just treasure sense. Okay. I gotta watch out for that. I keep confusing the two, but treasure sense is very distinct from Amrita sense. Okay, this is the second shortcut, right? Nope, just right by the first shortcut. Okay, so this was the path I took around. I already went down there, got all the treasure. I don't know how I get up on these ledges. That's not actually that long a trip from the previous shrine. So I'm gonna see how much further I can explore. Hopefully not take out too many enemies in the meantime. Is there like nothing here apart from this? I mean, I guess there isn't. I might as well just use the shrine. See if maybe I got my little EXP buff from one of them. How do I get the... Do I have to drop down from above? Oh, jeez. That'll be something. And then I'm going to be able to kick something down to get here later. Okay. Can I get Oracle Blessing? Nope. Guess not. Can't even level up. How much do I have in the way of usable items to get Amrita? I got 60,000. 62,000. 67,000. Would that be enough to level up? Not even. Okay. Amrita costs get pretty high pretty quick, it seems like. Oh, hello. Let me just... Oh, I ran by accident at the last second. I got too eager. Finish that guy off and... Hello? Oh, hello. Well, bye. Really don't feel like fighting that. Oh, wait, so where am I going? Huh. Wait a second. I'm not entirely sure. I know where I'm going. I guess, is it in here? Yeah, it has to be. This is the only way left. That's a Tengu. That's a pit. With a Kodama, though. I want to save him! Okay, I thought I was dead for a second there, but yeah, sure, we'll take it. Get home, little guy. And also, please tell no one about me falling off a ledge to find you. I'm gonna save my dogs for use against that Tengu. More dung. I suppose I can always go trade them into the guy to try to get his helmet later. It's not even a very attractive helmet, but it's unique. Nice try? I mean, if you're dead, they didn't really try. They kind of succeeded. Okay, and now that he's electrified, all of my attacks get the 30% buff, even if they're not electric themselves. Which, yeah, pretty useful. I wonder if level 102 is the average item level of their armor, or them. I'm thinking it's just them. Which means there's really no guarantee you'll be fighting against someone with good armor to steal, admittedly. Toss on a quick regen, fight some more. Cut down by Tengu. No, you don't. There's another Kodama nearby. Right here. Oh, wow, that's perilous. Okay. You had better be careful with that whole... Yeah, don't do that. Pardon me while I just hide in this hole, desperately trying to not die. Alright. I think that's all of it then. Yeah, if he'd tackled me, would I have just flown off the edge with him there? Would I have taken us both out? I feel like that's what it would have done. So, pretty glad that didn't work out for him then. I'm gonna need to switch to Roaring Gun. That guy has a hat. Oh, he guarded. Also, uh-oh. Bunch of dudes. Ninja slaying samurai. Alright. I don't know, man. It's pretty harsh so far from what I've seen. I'm not sure. Oh, fuck no. Yeah, that's death. Okay. I was kinda hoping that wouldn't happen. trying to dodge to the side, but he tracked. Does the stance wheel see much fiddling with? Yeah, I mean, it definitely has use. I don't use low stance hardly at all. That one's kind of, I'm not gonna say worthless, but, yeah, worthless. Actually, I will say it. Oh, he gave me a better arrow for the arrow I hit him with. I'll take it. But, like, high stance is actually quite useful. Use it quite a bit. It's just slower, more powerful attacks, but use it with any type of weapon. You don't necessarily need a specific weapon to get more powerful hits. Ow. Fuck. And you need to have your weapon sheathed to use stuff like, EI. So that's kind of EI's whole thing, if I remember right. Slowing talismans, pretty much exclusively for use against Tengu and those big tongue demons, though. The biggest assholes in the party. Also, I do have it set where if I switch stances after using Ki Pulse, it recovers more Ki than it would otherwise. So it gives me, like, a chunk of my bar back if I swap like that. Now, where did I die? It was at the end of this hall, right? Not down there. That was just a couple of dudes. And, yeah, here. By these good dogs. So I gotta cut right as soon as I get in here. There we go. Just immediately hit him with that. I'm in no mood to fuck around with him. Burst him down with the bar. Oh, I've still got a ton of it left. Let me actually go get those other guys. While I have dogs left. I mean, might as well. If you got them, use them. Down a ladder to the shrine, so I got a shortcut now. Oh, is there anything else? Or was this just where I fought the demon? Just where I fought the demon, and that was a one-time thing. Awesome. So now, I have free reign on this area whenever. God. I have a lot of time with these dogs. Why do I have so much dog time? I mean, I like it. It just seems like normally that lasts for significantly less time than it did right there. So sort of like choosing one or two hand and souls or switching weapon forms in Bloodborne. Yeah. Yeah, that... No, yeah, that seems correct. I don't... That is an accurate comparison to make. There's a Kodama around here, and also a bunch of asshole bats. Yeah. And one of these. Two of these guys. Just trying to ruin a day. Luckily, they're letting me land... Oh, no thank you. They're letting me land moves fairly easily. So it's not so bad. They're doing the thing that puts them in prone state for that hit. Now, Kodama, get home. Low stance is better with other weapon types. I mean, low stance is fine, it just doesn't do a lot of damage. I'm pretty sure it applies debuff pretty quickly, which seems like a good use, but... it also strikes fast and with less power, so if you absolutely need... to not hit them as hard, but hit them much more quickly, kind of like an interrupt sort of stance. That could work. But... Oh, wow, okay, so I need to be way over to the side to dodge that guy. You just don't care that a shot just came from above you to take out your buddy? Here. I know you got a helmet on, but that's roaring gun ammo, that one. Switch back to regular ammo, switch back to bow. feel like I didn't explore a lot of this cave. Is there more here? More shortcuts? Something like that fell to death. Pass. We'll definitely stay away from that. Oh, also, I went into this fight with not much health. I should fix that. There we go. I suppose if you came from behind me, wherever behind me is coming from on the mountain, that would have put you at a bit of a disadvantage since you had a gunman and a bowman and a dude on the other side of that bridge. What sword is that? Is that the one I have equipped? Yeah, that's the one I have equipped. Is it better than mine? If it has changed to attack heart, yeah, that's straight up better than mine. That's like 30 levels higher. I'll take it. Oh, holy shit. Yeah, okay. Thanks for giving me the sword I will use for a considerable amount of time. Let me just immediately whetstone that up. Get that to maximum power. How much more powerful is that than my old sword now? Lock this one instead. About 120 attack. That is why it is worth it to fight all these revenants. Occasionally you just find a dude with your sword, but way fucking better. Oh, no, I see why they fell to death now. There is a mine right in front of that item. So I don't know how mines can be disabled yet. Come on, perfect guard. What is the timing for perfect guard on this hit? Whatever. Whoa! Okay, that stun on you did not last hardly any time. Let me actually burn dogs for this fight. I was not anticipating having to, but there we go. That was brutal. Opponent, what weapon is that? Gives lightning damage, gives extra close combat damage, gives key reduction, and reduces guard key. What set is it from? It's not from any set, it's just a pair of lightning double swords. So that's probably really good for applying debuff. Let me actually try using that instead of my second current weapon. Now I kinda wish I hadn't used... Can I shoot it? Can I shoot the mine to take it out? I totally can. Good to know. And it's a full health medicine. Okay, I don't really use those, but that was way too close. Okay. Good to have. Cut down by Raven Tengu here? Like I said, good for applying debuffs. Oh, there's the Raven Tengu. Who the hell? You. Okay, let's switch to a holy arrow for undead boy over there. Oh, really? There we go. Let's try using this against the Raven Tengu, see if it works. Oh no. That's bad. That is extremely bad. Of all the things, possibly the worst. Okay, I slowed the Raven Tengu. I have like 30 seconds to kill this dude before Tengu is just on my ass. Not good at all. Okay, we're gonna have to kite this one a bit. Oh, I'm using holy arrows. Whoops. Did I get out of Tengu range? Is he still coming or am I good? A lot of people using these lightning swords. Let's see if maybe hitting in high stance applies more of debuff. No, it seems like same amount of debuff. But he does hardly any damage. Like, I am also not doing, like, any damage with these hits. I'm taking a lot of stamina. Okay, that's what it is. Your goal is to wear out stamina. So you can land that special hit. That does a lot of damage. Okay. Yeah, that was... I don't know how I feel about these. I feel like they'll be pretty good against big, slow enemies, just because I'll be able to apply that lightning debuff pretty quick. But, against people? Not so much. I am out of sloth talismans against the Tengu. Oh, shit. That hurt a lot. Please stop that. Oh man, yeah, this is gonna suck. Oh, I applied the debuff. So now he is slowed, I think, is the effect of lightning debuff. And I'm dealing 800 damage a slice, because I got a bonus 30% damage. Well, that happens. That's still... extremely rough to try to fight him with dual swords. Seems like trying to stamina out a Tengu might be the best move, but even then, not easy. There's a Kodama over here. Get to the shrine, buddy. Is there something this way? No, and I've already been here, apparently. Yeah, this is where I fought the two dudes. Okay, so... could I have just taken this path instead of dropping down, and that would have gotten me past the Tengu without having to fight him? I mean, that's ultimately... that would have been fine, but... oh, he's using an axe. But... well, bamboo forest. And some dudes fighting on their own again. I don't know who the factions here are. Here, while you guys are fighting, let me go look into some dual sword skills. Because I haven't looked into them much. Sign of the Cross. Quick draw can only be used when your sword is sheathed. Greatly reduces time necessary to gather energy. Close combat damage increased 10% against enemies with full life gauges. So, sneaky attacks. Mid or low stance follows up a combo with a roundhouse kick. That is, yeah, that's the kick. I love that. Allows you to combo another hit after that. You can double slice with good timing. Oh. Okay, that seems nice. Follows up a combo with a jumping slice. It's pretty basic. A spinning attack that slices all around you. Oh, generate an actual tornado with Windstorm. Thrust a sword while simultaneously guarding. Okay, it's dual swords, that makes sense. Plus 10 recovery speed while guarding, okay. Parries an enemy's attack. You guys are still fighting over there, huh? Alright. So what's the difference? Rushes forward while swinging two swords. Yeah, I remember that move. A legendary samurai move with kind of flailing your arms. Wait, dodges attacks that come at you while you're recovering from an evasive move. Does that mean that anything that hits me, does it increase iframes basically, or give me a second dodge? And increase the attack power when it succeeds. Alright, dual swords have a really weird moveset. I'm not sure I get it. Are you guys done fighting yet? Nope. Still going at it. Well, have fun, you kids. Never mind. This looks like the correct way to go. Do you have treasure back there? Maybe? A Kodama? Anything else? Oh, hey, there we go. One guy's dead. And that dead guy dropped his own grave. Cut down by rogue, yeah. That just happened. Why am I trying to perfect dodge these? That won't do anything for me anymore. I really don't get how I'm supposed to use dual swords yet. Used an elixir. That's my shtick, asshole. Yeah, how do you like it, huh? Samurai General's armor. Yeah, tons of it. Have I leveled their moveset? Not much, but even then, looking at the moveset, like a lot of it, I don't really understand how it's supposed to combo together. Oh, okay. That can't be all of them. Find them. Surprise, I'm not one of them, but hello. He's not aware. What? Oh, he's aware, though. And his friend is aware. I get plenty of samurai skill points for proficiency with dual swords here, though, considering I've like never used them and now I've got a high level pair equipped. So that's nice. And then eventually, if I get up to what was it, like, oh, that was a, I thought that looked funny. It was a mine, that's why. If I get up to full 500,000, I can unlock their mystic arts. Oh, speaking of hot springs. Yeah, man. I'm digging it, too. Okay. Still haven't found the rest of the Kodama. Got a lot left there to find, just in general. Yeah, I mean, the damage doesn't seem too bad, just in mid-stance. If I switch to high... I got some Onmyo Mage stuff there? And I still haven't found the shortcut back to the base of the mountain, where there was a second ladder to kick down, now that I'm thinking about it. Oh, he's one of the ones that leaves the grave. Okay, high stance for these swords seems to be exactly the kind of playstyle that I'm digging. Because it hits at about the same speed as mid stance for a regular sword. Like, it says there's a yokai down there somewhere, but hell if I'm gonna climb down there. Not enough to kill a guy, now you're killing his ghost too. Multiple guys! That's been a theme throughout this entire level. So these guys are all coming back as vengeful spirits after I hit them once. Kodama over here. Yeah, I'm completely all turned around as to where I am on this mountain. But I do know that I haven't seen a shrine for a while. So, I don't know. I want to go back a little bit and find out what other stuff was in that area I just kind of passed by. Yeah, because there was this entire path that I just didn't take. I turned around because it looked like the right way. The problem is pretty much everywhere in this mission is looking like I'm going the right way. Oh, is this that shortcut from the beginning of the mission? I hope so. Okay, you I want to use regular mid stance again. Alright, yeah, that's pretty good. That seems okay. I'm just gonna leave real quick. I'm gonna take a little step away from that there. See if I can take out one ear. Who's got the horn? Who will alert everybody in the area? It's you. Choked a lot. I mean, I don't know why I'm trying to perfect guard with a weapon set that doesn't have the perfect guard ability on it. Low stance just doesn't feel very good to me. Hello? And now I'm back in sort of the same area I was in a minute ago. Yeah, there's the bridge. Okay, so now I'm back to where I was anyway. So, just a nice little circular area, which means I did miss something near the beginning of the level then. If I never found the way to get back down there to take out that yokai and get that shortcut. Oh, hello. They seem to be pretty good stealthy boy tools. Deal some decent damage with backstabs. So maybe that's their purpose? I don't know. They seem best against big lumbering enemies. Above all else. Whereas against a person... Sword is easily the best for the perfect guard ability. Going against people with big move sets that you know? Yep, that's a perfect guard. It's an enemy you can perfect guard against. Wow, that's a lot of the Adagarasu armor. What is that? That was the armor set that gave me, Strategist of Legend, skill key damage, key, skill key reduction. Extend timely guard opening seems quite good. But my helmet is just insane. So I don't think I'll be equipping that anytime soon. But let's see what... I'm pretty sure this armor set had the... Yeah, it was the one that gave auto-target weak spot for quick headshots. Of course it's one of them. Why wouldn't it be? And I'm still out of sloth talismans. That's... I don't think I've had one of those for a bit yet. That's alright though. I have lightning on my dual swords. So, 30% bonus damage now. And we can just keep applying that debuff. Fighting this guy on a hill seems quite nice. A lot of his attacks don't really stretch down far enough to hit me. So he was facing this way, so I think the game expected me to be coming from this direction? Oh. That's the sound of a shrine, yep. I've still barely found any Kodama. Which, like, damn. Oh, hello. What were you looking at? Wait, this wasn't bamboo forest from earlier, was it? Oh my god! How's that for a roundabout way to get somewhere? Jesus Christ. I could have just headed a bit further this way, and boom, we're here. Maybe this door only opened from one way, though. A lot of them do that. So now that's my shortcut to get back, is that door is open? Well, it's been nice, but... Oh, wow, you got some reflexes, don't you, buddy? Just dodged a gunshot in the time it took him to hear it. And then that dude's grave is still down here, since they took out a guy who was a large red circle. Oyama Hoku. Thank you. And this is just an empty path. So, I think the way I haven't explored is this way then. Through this area down here. Hello. Yeah, hi. Alright, well, bye. Take easy. Oh no, here it is. You've been running quite a ways, haven't you? Yeah, it seems like between the long attack chains and the very few ways to break a guard, they're definitely more for use against yokai than they are against people. Unless, of course, you get somebody who, for whatever reason, just cannot guard. In which case, yeah, they'd be pretty good, I guess. So what's in this hole if my goal is the other way? Oh, another shrine. And, oh, that's tricky. Dude, it's literally just behind me. That little guy was just... I mean, he was being a little bit lazy. He was just kind of waiting for somebody to point him behind him. A little bit more skill. Come to think of it, if I'm going to be using these dual swords, I still have a sword with change to attack skill that can be inherited. So... I mean, I just have to get rid of one of these effects, and it will get that ability. An A+ change to skill, which, pretty good. 80,000, huh? Anyway, let's also switch to Oracle Blessing. And I only have one more Kodama to find. I found 8 of them in this level, and it really doesn't feel like I have, but... I guess... Wow, his weapon deals like no damage. Dude, you seriously need to upgrade that if you're this late in the game with an axe that does that much per hit. It's like, damn man. Oh no! I'm sorry I talk shit about your axe! I ran out of stamina because I was talking shit, Really though, he does need an axe that deals more damage than that. It'll take tons of stamina, but it won't actually deal that much damage. Really? Yeah, just heard you were talking shit. He sticks his axe's handle into my gut and I go flying. Everyone's wearing that red demon armor, man. Absolutely everyone. Oh right, everybody respawned. It's not ideal. Oh, last Kodama is just upstairs. Awesome, that's what I was looking for. So I have no trouble just going to finish off the mission now if that... Dang it. They really need a guardrail. Don't mind me. Just passing by. Yeah, there we go. That's all 9. Bloody Spirit Nunchuck. Sorry, guy. Why have all of these guys been, like, bald with the bandage on their head? Oh wait, is that a... Oh shit. Mob Psycho 100 might have taught me something. Is that a thing? Is that, is that like... what was his name? Why can't I remember the dude's name? He's the good boy from Mob. Teru, is that like, he's, Teru, when he was fighting Teru, he cut off all his hair? He's like, you just thought I looked like an... I want to say he said Onimusha? No, no, that's not right. That's a game, isn't it? You just thought I looked like a, shit, what did he say? That's gonna kill me until I remember. Oh wait, it's the name of an episode, so I can just look that up real easy. Ochimusha. So let me just look that up real quick. Ochimusha is a defeated warrior that fled the enemy. Is considered a low-class citizen, no longer at the level of a samurai since he fled battle instead of committing seppuku. In some instances, it seemed to escape safely. Those warriors hide themselves in mountain villages. Okay. The iconography usually represents the Ochimusha with the crown of his head shaved and the rest of the hair long and loose. The dissolved would then mean losing the social status of the samurai. Arrows stuck in the body are also a common motif. So these are all guys who have fled battle, so they're all Ochimusha. I learned a thing from Mob Psycho 100. Hi. Ishida Mitsunari. Wait a second. Whoa, those are some sword beams. That did a shitload of damage. Oh my god. Wow. Okay. Hold up. Okay, let's get over here. And I am gonna summon the dogs to purge this area. Come on, afflict him with lightning debuff. Is he already afflicted? Okay, yeah, he is. He's moving slower. Okay. Wow, that did not last for very long on him, though. Whoa! That was brutal. Oh shit, it's Mitsunari. He was a big deal historically. What? Did I just get pile-drived by a fucking guardian spirit? That is incredibly painful. Uh-oh, I'm dead. No, I'm not, surprisingly. I fully anticipated being dead there. Oh my god. That's another pile driver. Am I dead now? Still no, surprisingly. Jesus. Today on I Shouldn't Be Alive. Whatever that shit was. They just strike through guards. I don't know how to guard against wind attacks, because they keep doing that. Likewise, guy. I'm summoning my own guardian spirit. You're doing wind, I'm doing lightning dogs. Full offensive with lightning dog, boys. Got him. Okay. Oh, alright. So that guy does a ton of damage that can just pierce through guards. So either you gotta be real good at your dodge timer, you gotta damage race him. Well, let's check the historical documents for Ishida Mitsunari. He got me with several grabs. Did you mean the one that was a dragon pile driving me? Or the one where he just threw me to the ground? Or... Oh wait, that was the commander from the previous fight, wasn't it? Yeah, Ishida Mitsunari was the one who gave the go-ahead to summon the giant demon. Oh shit, am I gonna get his dog dragon?
Sambai no Chao Kyoshi. Jusan no Tokikara Tsukaeta. Hideyoshi sama.
Yeah, I got the pile driver from the fox spirit. Oh, it's a fox.
Taiko sama ni. Tsuite iku dake de atta. Gyo o monji.
Hideyoshi's dead? So wait, he's the one who betrayed Nobunaga. Tenkai was a Buddhist monk of high rank who served as an advisor to few of the Tokugawa shoguns. By itself, this isn't noteworthy, but some legends maintain that Tenkai was actually Akechi Mitsuhide, who found a new life after betraying Oda Nobunaga. There's much speculation about why Mitsuhide betrayed his lord. Most perceive it as a grab for power. However, some say it was the result of a grudge held against him after he threw a piece of Mitsuhide's dinnerware into a pond. A more romantic legend claims that Nobunaga himself told Mitsuhide to kill him should his ambition ever cause him to become too ruthless. His final days are unclear. He held the position of shogun for 13 days before being deposed. History suggests he was killed on the road by a peasant with a bamboo spear. Nioh takes the legends literally, portraying Tenkai as a reformed Mitsuhide. Huh. Oh, this article has a lot of historical figures in it. Yeah, so basically Nobunaga conquered a huge chunk of Japan was betrayed by Mitsuhide and beheaded. Hideyoshi went after him and decapitated him and used this as a base to take control of Nobunaga's power base. Hideyoshi then dies, and Ishida and Tokugawa champion different successors. Okay. Huh. And then, some big leaders. William. The game's main protagonist is William, is largely fictional, but is based on the real-life William Adams. Adams is credited as the first Englishman to travel to Japan. During his time in the nation, he met with Tokugawa Ieyasu multiple times. Ieyasu was the Lord of Edo and future shogun of Japan. Adams became a close confidant to Ieyasu and was eventually declared a samurai. He was forbidden from leaving Japan and given the name Miura Anjin. He spent the rest of his life there helping to foster trade. Edward Kelly is one of the main antagonists. In real life, Kelly was an English occultist and alchemist who claimed he could summon and communicate with spirits using a magical mirror. Oh shit, he's a time traveler with a smartphone. And recorded conversations. Damn. I mean, that's what everyone says they would do. Here, observe my magic mirror. Also, I am actually, you know, some crazy dude. How would you recharge the smartphone? Damn. He worked closely with John Dee, famed philosopher, an advisor to Queen Elizabeth. While in his service, he supposedly used a magical red powder to transform metal into gold. Tokugawa Ieyasu, the man who unified Japan and ended the Sengoku period. That's Tanuki Boy, by the way. Originally named Matsudiara Takachiyo, he spent much of his youth as a hostage of the Imagawa clan. Following his release, he proved an intelligent military mind. He declared independence from the Imagawa and joined with the famed General Oda Nobunaga. He and Nobunaga worked to unify the land and made good progress until he was betrayed by Mitsuhide, we now know. Following this, Ieyasu fought warlord Toyotomi Hideyoshi to a standstill and agreed to become his vassal. He served Hideyoshi as his lord, pushed to unify Japan, although he did not send forces when he attempted to invade Korea in a disastrous campaign. After Hideyoshi died, Ieyasu's surplus of troops made it easy for him to push for his leadership into Japan. At the Battle of Sekigahara, which we were at now, that was the one where I'm pretty sure in real life a giant demon didn't get summoned. He defeated Ishida Mitsunari and was declared shogun. So this is where we're at historically right now, is him like finishing off the remnants of the Battle of Sekigahara and becoming shogun. Because is already dead, and that was the last like person standing in his way of a bid for power. He served 2 years before abdicating the position to his son. His patience was legendary. In a poem about the major figures of the Sengoku period, when asked what he would do if a bird would not sing for him, he merely replied, Wait. Alright. His other most famous act came after Oda this is about Hanzo. His other most famous act came after Oda Nobunaga was betrayed by Akechi Mitsuhide. Hanzo loyally guided the vulnerable Iyasu into safe territory. History says that Hattori Hanzo died of sickness before he unified the nation. But some legends maintain he was killed during a naval battle after the ship he was on was lit on fire. Either way, that kind of sucks for him. Mission A True Ninja, A Greater Harmony have been added to... Wait, what? What are those? And can I can't take them, right? Yeah, 20 decks or 20... I guess those are for the final upgrades. I'm so close to getting a True Ninja, actually. I'm pretty far from a Greater Harmony. And how am I doing for... I'm actually not doing too bad on that one. Got some decent dual sword proficiency going. And the Black Samurai here is a real guy who did serve Nobunaga. He was actually in the article as well. Let me go find him real quick. One more bit of history, though I don't know that we've seen him yet. Yasuke was a samurai of African descent who served Oda Nobunaga. It is unclear what his birth name was or where exactly he came from, though some sources say Mozambique. He served Nobunaga faithfully and is said that they enjoyed conversation together. When he was betrayed, Yasuke fought at the Temple of Honnoji and later fought for Nobunaga's son, Nobutada. He eventually turned his sword in to Mitsuhide's forces and was spared from death and sent to a Jesuit missionary. After that, no one knows. Okay. Cool. I just went and confirmed that something was familiar. Oh, yeah, hold on one sec. What are commands? I should probably fix that. There you go, Loon. That should fix that. I should probably actually set up some mods for my channel at some point, but it really has... Everyone's behaved really well, and I appreciate that. We have not yet had need for mods. Yeah, you can't actually be sure. Oh yeah, level 100 achievement. Can't actually be sure a giant, huge skeleton monster didn't show up to that battle. There's no real stuff one way or the other. Alright. Oh. I guess the Twilight missions have changed. Which probably means, Oh, it happens at 11 p.m. Okay, that's good to know. Also, Blacksmith, it's time to do a couple of things. First off, soul match, weapon, my dual swords that I stole off of somebody. Level 117, by the way. Damn. And then we are going to shove this change to attack skill on it. That is A-. And soul match it. Damn, that is now an extremely good pair of dual swords. You got anything good for me to buy? Special finds. Yoichi's bow. Oof, that looks cool, but I don't think I need it. Oh, here we go. Arrows, rifle ammunition, hand cannon ammunition. I'm already full on that one, okay. I'm wondering if I shouldn't... Yeah, I'm thinking I shouldn't do that. I've already reset my stuff like twice using the free ones. The novel Shogun by James Clavell, a dramatization of the life of the same fellow this story is based on. Fictional account mostly follows the events but with all the names turned sideways. Nice. Okay, we got a side mission. I can make sake once I've gone to this mission. Villager was driven by his desperate situation to abandon his aged mother. Detestable custom, now however, roots of a demon, and the man regrets his actions bitterly. He wants to bring his mother home. Aww. That is a really shitty tradition, yeah. You know what, let's actually... Let me make his locks. And also... Whetstones. Let's max out these new dual swords, now that they have that extra bonus from skill. And then I think skill is the next one I put points into once everything's at 15. Unless I want to get magic and dex to 20. Because... I don't know. In any case, I did not break all of my stuff at the blacksmith, now that I'm thinking about it, which seems like a bit of a mistake in hindsight, but whatever. But I was going to ready this lightning talisman... I'm often not using the Rejuvenation Talisman, so Lightning Talisman it is. Force Sloth Talismans is pretty much required, though. That's really good. I'm just gonna keep that. Improved Projectiles and Tiger Run. I can ready all of them. I might as well. I mean, I'm not gonna actually use them, but... let me just put the Lightning Talisman instead of the Heroku Dama. Since I never really use Heroku Dama. So I think that was for hitting 100,000 with dual swords. Regen Talisman, please. And an elixir. I did not see that demon at all before he popped out there. What'd you guys die from? Burned to death? I can take a guess. Fell to death. Oh, well, that sucks. Oh, and there's a big boy that's gonna pop up as soon as I start walking across this. Oh, that's tricky. That dude has a hand cannon on the other side. There we go. And hopefully he'll have dropped ammo now, too. Oh, please be careful. Just saying that to myself, don't mind me. As I nearly fucking beef it off of a ledge for the billionth time. Okay, him naming you Anjin is because, like, what kind of fucking name is William, basically? My name is Anjin. Actually, that name sucks. Here's your name. Okay, yeah, no, that's way better against larger beasts. So, yeah, regular sword. Oh, hell and no. You are getting an extreme shot to the dome there. I really hate those guys. What did you all die from? What one-eyed Oni? Okay, just the guy I just killed. Pretty quickly. Okay, I now see. The dual swords are a yokai fighting item. They are not really as useful against people, but they are unbelievably useful against yokai. That makes sense. And that's pretty much just pure damage that you're putting out. You really don't have much utility from them, but they're extremely good at hitting things in the fucking face. Oh, that's not okay. Wow, that hurt. Oh, no you don't. I like those little saving bits you get there. You're about to fall off a ledge. Roll to dodge. Also, this is easily getting my lightning abilities up. So, dual swords versus Tengu make them slightly more tolerable. Also, this is where that hot spring was, so I will definitely take that. Please and thank you. I don't want to run to that mine on the way out. That'd be embarrassing. Okay, let's take the hot spring. Had that connect to seeing someone call you Mr. Pilot, a name which Shogun makes a fine gag out of, as Notwell Adams is renamed Jonathan Blackthorn, which Japanese characters find impossible to wrangle, so they just call him Boatman. Is that Anjin? Anjin is like Boatman? I'm honestly not sure. I'm asking for confirmation from someone that has a finer grasp on the language than I do. Which is to say, any grasp on the language. Stay out of the way of Gunman, thank you. Oh, I am still in high stance. Anjin is roughly pilot or steersman. Okay. Cool. I'm learning things. One thing that I really like about this game that I haven't talked a lot about, I don't think, maybe I did while I was kind of out of it one day, is that I really enjoy games that take a semi-historical context and just kind of roll with it. Because I'm actually going to go back to something I saw on the web series Extra Credits way back when, which is semi-historical games, games that take like a historical idea and then just roll with it, putting their own spin on it, are often extremely cool because they get people interested in the actual historical events surrounding whatever is happening in the game. Because I guarantee you, I would not have learned this much about this period in history without playing Nioh. And while now my perception of the event is kind of, you know, colored by the fact that, yeah, I fought a bunch of demons while I was learning about it, it's still really cool to learn. Yeah, like the Warrior series, we'll just drop a name, like, here's blank character, and I'll be like, oh, that's cool. Who is this? And it's like, it's Lana, she's actually an original character to Hyrule Wars, and I'm like, ah, okay, I don't care, and that's why she seems so different from everyone else. But no, in all seriousness, I'm getting a lot of dual sword proficiency points real quick. That bonus 30% against electrified enemies is proving pretty handy. Finally convincing people to learn about the Zelda timeline, that's right. Wait, so like there's one where it floods? Is that the one where... So there are three timelines created at the end of Oracle of... or Ocarina of Time, you're saying. And in one of them, he's a kid and just goes through life regularly. In one of them, he's an adult that goes through life regularly. And in the other one, he no longer exists because it's the timeline where they defeated Ganon and then they sent him back home. Okay. And you're saying that the original Legend of Zelda is actually very deep in these timelines and not the original game. And that the first game in the series is actually... Breath of the Wild? No, not Breath of the Wild. It's the one with the Skyward Sword. And that's where they originally make the Master Sword. Okay, that sounds all right. Oh, okay, hi. I accidentally broke the demon. I actually much prefer lightning though, so excuse me while I fix my swords. Uh-oh. Oh, that's why this is dangerous. No! Shit. I didn't even notice I was on fire until it was too late. Okay. Past Wind Cake, Majora's Past Wind Death, Gamelon. I see. Oh, right, because, like, the reason for the kid timeline is that they reveal that Ganondorf is evil ahead of time, so things never get rolling. Because Kid Zelda's just like, yo, Dad, this guy's mad fucked up. Can we please not hire him as an advisor of sorts? I never even thought about making these guys try to charge into a wall. I guess, yeah, that'd work, wouldn't it? Future Loose Cake Mario Brothers Super Show cartoon. That's... Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's how it happens. Once I get dogs back, I should really keep trying to use dual swords if I'm trying to level them up enough. That's just real quick. Oh wait, I'm just gonna get this overridden by a fire buff as soon as I kill this guy. Damn it. Oh well. Whoa, that hurt. What the hell was that? Did I, like, overload him? With fire or something? And an Onryoki. Yeah, I overloaded them with their element. I didn't even realize that was possible. So if you inflict an enemy that has an element with more of the element, it explodes? I never knew that. It never came up. Uh-oh. Hey, buddy, I'll kill you when my buff's about to wear off, alright? Oh, that hurt. I still don't know what wind buff does, Oh, he's unsloth, that's why. No wonder he's moving so fast. Got a different debuff? Wait. He got a special kind of debuff because I think I inflicted two elements on him at the same time? I've never seen that debuff icon pop up before. I'm gonna be real with you. These are very good for applying an element quickly, though. Damn. Okay, so that is what low stance is for on dual swords, is you immediately trigger whatever type of elemental buff or debuff you were getting at. Aw, it's fucked up. No. Damn it. No, don't do that! Don't do that to me! Aw, this mission sucks! One minute you're talking about Legend of Zelda lore, the next one you're sad. Discord, apply any two elemental debuffs to an enemy at the same time, instant key drain, and no key regeneration, and extra damage, and every attack staggers an enemy. What the fuck? That's insane! Shrine, level up. More skill. So how close am I to... I'm almost to 200,000 already. Dual swords are leveling up pretty fast. And I got like 300 items to break at the blacksmith. So what does this Daijin Zinsaki do again? Protection, curing, and temporarily preventing elemental base damage. Oh, okay, cool. So it fixes elements. Did I get anything higher level than my current sword, and can I do that without breaking the bank? Wait, is soul matching cost way lower if they're maximum familiarity? Because otherwise that just costs 20,000 for no apparent reason. Also, can I upgrade these two? Well, I guess I've found my two weapons now. I'm just gonna keep using. Let me see if I can reforge anything on these. I don't want either of those. Don't want either of those. Midgard key reduction, I'll take that. Use that all the time. Skill key damage, don't really care about that. Low attack key reduction, don't really care about that. Low attack break. Final blow damage, sure, it's something. It's better than what I had. Lock that again. And this. Close combat damage plus 7.6 is real nice. Final blow damage I'll keep. I just only got rid of final blow damage, didn't I? Nice. Nice. Okay, all rare on here. Life recovery by final blow, 150. So if I kill something with them, I get 150 health back. Close combat key damage, plus 5.2%. That's great. Both of those are excellent. I'll take them. Oh no, wait, I can... Hold on. I have a request for you. Increase the upper level for forged items. Make it possible for me to get better shit. It is gonna take forever to max those out. I don't think I will, like, that's just something that's not gonna happen for me. And all armor. Well, there you go. Like, what's equipped right now? What two things do I have? This one's a really good sense enemies one. Do I have a higher level Kodama sense? Probably not, unless I got a legendary. That's the only thing I've found Kodama sense on so far. Okay, on that note... That's pretty good. Stealth for yokai, A-. That's really good. Yeah, sell all that shit for a ton of money. I'm guessing the axe. I mean, I have all my good gear equipped, so I'm not too worried about it. And now you probably have... You have no more dialogue stuff for me after I just sold you that much shit? Really? Any of these have good inheritance? No. Yeah, it's strictly worse than mine. It's only level 28. Because I got it off of the boss himself, I think. So, what else do I need to do? Anything? Oh yeah! Refashion weapon. My gun. That I have equipped. Into Ravenwing rifle. Because it looks sick. Wait, my gun is level 73? Can I make a new one? No, I don't have any great centipede fangs. Even a regular matchlock, though. Yeah, okay. Equip that. Instead of the Sakai rifle. And I can make a new Warrior of the West bow, but... Mine is pretty good. The item level is way higher, though. Should I try to get a better one? I mean, even at lowest attack, it's going to be better than the one I currently have. But it came out legendary anyway and has way more attack now. Okay, great. I think that's probably it for you folks then. Refashion, weapon, gun into sick looking... Raven gun. And the rest of it is fine. Nothing to disassemble, so that's okay. So yeah, Discord, the debuff, is crazy. Kind of makes me want to upgrade my lightning talismans with Onmia a little bit more so I can carry more of them. And then I can just switch from, like, lightning to fire or something. I also got a ton of other stuff. But anyway, I think it's finally time to actually go forward with a mission. I've been messing around with menus for far too long. So now we have bird rifle. Oh my god, look at the little like glowing runes along the side. It's an extremely good looking bird rifle. Oh yeah, I was going to equip the new better prayer beads. Wait, enemy paralyzed. Oh, that's the debuff paralyzed, not electric damage. Because that would have been way too good. That was on there. But anyway. Do I have anything that is not familiar with me right now? All of it. Okay, yeah, it's worth, again, probably worth the whetstones to just immediately max out the familiarity of four different items. Cut down by Amrita Fiend. Oh, that guy. Hi there. Yeah, it's okay, I guess. Naomasa. I think I already fought Naomasa, right? Naomasa is either two I's or an I and an L. Oh, you're gonna step on. Yep. Stupid motherfucker. That's right, I saw the panel. So this is one of the kind of hidden doors are cool types of dungeons. And hidden switches are also cool. I just hope it's not a secret turning walls are cool kind of place. Oh. Oh. That is a nasty looking hell reactor? Okay, that looks like some shit out of Doom. Is what I'm saying. It's just making more of these guys, I guess. Okay, time to overload this guy and see if he does, in fact, explode like I thought he was. Yeah, there it is. Hit him with the same element, he exploded. And he falls over before he does it, too, just to telegraph that it's gonna happen. Shit. How did I never know about that? Did it just never come up, or... Come this way, please. Oh, and I have electric sword for you. Yeah, you're gonna love this, right? Yeah, they're glowing brighter as I deal more damage to him. Yep, there he goes. Hahaha. Yeah, a blood pillar. Yeah, just in the middle of the zone. For reasons that are not entirely clear to me. This place is real spooky. And there's another shrine here already. I feel like the shrine's a bit early. Oh, it's one of the fast boys. Okay, this isn't... No! I gotta stick to dual swords! What the fuck? That was a lot of damage. Okay. Well, at least it was easy to get there. Just had to cut my way through a couple of Amrita boys. He steps on the button, gets himself shot. Get it to wander around, grab some free items. I think I hooked a left to get through here. Did I open this door? I feel like I didn't. This looks like somewhere different from where I've gone before. There's an enemy right here on the other side of this wall. Door is locked. I do not have the key. There's a tanuki in there. Oh, I was right here. Do you explode now? Nope. Still no explode? Oh, okay. We'll keep going then. Walk politely through the door, thank you. Ooh. Now he explodes. Oh, is this where the key is? No, it's just powder. Okay, Hell Pillar stays gone. Which is quite notable. Need to switch to high stance to fight this boy, because it's usually one hit, and then kind of leave him alone. That hurt. Oh, shoot. I had to blow those up, didn't I? Okay, hold on. There's a shrine right here, right? Yeah, okay. Oh, and I can just open this door from this side. Let me go back and blow up that wall, because I am 99% certain I can blow up that wall. And I can level up in the meantime. Seven bonus attack from one skill. That's A scaling for you, I guess. So now I just want to hook a left here. Ow. Dick. Also, one thing I really like about this weapon, just the fact that the damage text takes a while to show up after the fact. Did that actually blow a hole in the wall? It did. Oh, shit. I gotta be on the lookout for more walls like this one. Near explosive barrels. And there was a Kodama past that. Buddy, I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm glad I found that. Oh, that's... I have a feeling that guy would have tried to throw explosives at me if I came at this without first coming through here. Oh, plenty of explosive rounds to help me out, though. Is this Blood Pillar Room? Yeah, it is. So now I about got my... Another spider room with a Kodama. Never mind, I'm fine being dropped down here. I can save the good boy. He's in here somewhere. Get away from my very good boy. It's okay, small child. I'm here. Thank goodness that thing dropped me into the dung pit. I never would have found the good boy if it hadn't. Yeah, what's with the mass grave down here, though? Yeah, why do you have a giant pile of human corpses dungeon just lying around the place? That's not ideal. To say the least. Oh! I'll bet that's another place I can get dropped into this dungeon. And it is an actual, real-ass dungeon this time. Now that I've made it out of Hell Dungeon, where are we? I've lost my bearings. I fucking knew it. Trying to be real tricky and hide behind here so I wouldn't see him. Go straight for that boy guard in the chest. Oh, that hurt. Oh, you're one of the big ones. Right, that's not a tanuki. Lay down a regen and start sprinting around prison. It is actually a prison, too. What is with this place? Okay, I feel like I dodged that. But alright. Is there a Kodama in that cell with the two guys? I gotta find the jailer key or something. Oh, hello. Okay, yeah, I'll take it. Nice easy kill against a, one of them. Oh, and now I know where I am again. Which means I've still gotta find the prison warden's key somewhere. You step on that thing, get shot. Maybe upstairs this time? Oh, hey, demon wall. Anyone die nearby? No. Let's not mess with you until I kill this guy. Because I do not want to have to fight a wall and a big Amrita Oni at the same time. Oh, shoot, I moved too quickly. He noticed me. Oh, that's a grapple. That's not a thing I can guard against. Okay, so to get back to where I was, let's find a landmark here, because I'm much better with landmarks than I am with pretty much anything else. So stairs. It was past here. Right? Oh shit. What saw me? Oh, the guy throwing explosives in that room. That's fine. So that was the pit I got dropped down. Which means it was behind me, I guess? Oh, there's an elixir here. Oh, there's another demon tube in this room. And something I can explode? I mean, can I just throw an explosive at it? Or that probably has to be blown up from the other side to activate, doesn't it? Alright, so this is definitely not the way I went. No, so let's go backwards just a little bit and try to find where my souls got dropped off. Stairs here? Not the right set of stairs. And a door? Not even a door. Just a hidden door leading there. I am all kinds of turned around right now. Wow, really? The big guy didn't notice me at all there? I mean, I'll take it, but... Oh, here we go. Yeah, this guy was watching over right here. So that's where I ended up after all that before. Yeah, with dual swords, it seems like it'd be real easy to cause discord on any bigger enemies. Beaten to death by Amrita Fiend. Okay. Let's try the Kodama Dance. You're not digging the Kodama Dance. Okay. What about Resolute Stance? No, you didn't even react to that one. Okay, let's try that. What about a whistle? Okay. Yeah, whistle did it. Was, in fact, yellow that he was looking for. There's a Kodama under these stairs. I'm having a real trouble with hitting walls with dual swords, though. Okay, kick open this door. And where are we? We're right at the entrance. The first entrance, too. Okay, let's see if I can go back and re-find... You step on the switch, please. Oh, shit. I'm in the wrong place. Uh, let's see if I can refind that area with the... Wait, was it over there? Down a floor? Maybe? No, this is back to a dilapidated prison. Okay, so here's blue demon room. That's the hole I fell down. Path around the yellow boy. Yeah, wow, they just do not notice me if I pass by now. I guess that's the A-minus yokai not noticing you sense? Okay, let's fire a holy arrow at this guy at the end of the hall. Whoa, okay. That is a poison resist caplet, not a fire resist caplet. Buddy, please. He's about to explode. Yep, there we go. Can fire device no longer operational. Fire enemy still fully operational, and a pain in the ass. One more elixir. Okay, and there should be a shortcut around this room that I can open to the right. No enemies there. By blowing something up. Yep. I could hit it with my sword, but I'd prefer not to get hit by all that. Must be open from the other side. Okay.
I see. An excess of amrita causes the subject to swell to unsustainable levels.
Oh, are we finding notes? Research notes from the villain. I like it. Dude, you wanna come fight? Let's go. Oh, right, you have the slam that causes damage in an AoE. Let's fight in the big room, so I have a little ways to dodge around you. What do you say? Oh, and now I'm afflicted by lightning, because I got hit too much. He's about to explode. Shit. Got out of there just in time. So I guess this... Within the context of the game, I guess this castle was abandoned because Kelly was using it for Amrita research? I still don't have the key, do I? To any of these cells. Oh. Once I do have the key, I have to go rescue the Kodama in the other underground area. And he was using prisoners for experimentation. Okay. Warriors, warriors, cut down by Yoki. Come on. Uh-oh. I can open this door from this side. This huge underground secret experimentation prison is feeling very last acty. And this is the cell that I have to open once I get the key to get the Kodama out of it, despite the two enemies sitting in here. That small boy in the prison that I have to save is way more important. Alright, is there anything else down this hallway with all this stuff? There's an enemy in this room. Is there anything else in this room worthy of noting? Or, no? Just that? Okay. There's a Kodama in the next jail cell over. Must be open from the other side. Well, how can I break through a wall? I haven't seen any explosive barrels down here so far. So... further down, I guess? No, I can't see how going further down is going to give me a way to get that small boy out of prison, but... who? Oh, hi. Oh, though small boy is on this floor as well, so he's on one of the two floors. It's just around this corner. Yeah, there we go. So I only need the prison key to get one small boy out of prison now. I should upgrade my dual sword skills now that I'm getting this high up. Follows up a high stance combo with a jumping slice. There is somebody here. Hi. How's it going? Yeah, that's not really applying water debuff at all, is it? It's just gonna kill this guy before it takes effect. So water debuff is really not the strong suit of my other sword. It just kind of is there if I do enough damage. Alright, what other skills do I have? Mid-stance. Press button repeatedly to vary the technique. Increases slicing speed. Parries an enemy's attack with triangle while guarding. Sure. We'll take the rush forward. That sounds incredibly good, though. Like, when you successfully dodge an attack, or when you almost dodge an attack in low stance while locked onto something, it'll apparently dodge again? I'll have to see how often it triggers, but... it sounds very useful. Initial impressions are good. Hot spring! Oh wait, I think it just happened. Yeah, a dude was gonna hit me after I just did a low stance dodge. So it just did another dodge and completely dodged the damage. That's ridiculous. I'm staying in low stance all the time now. Prison keys? No? Warden's keys, anyone? Haha, hell no. Goodbye. My bird rifle should do the trick. Apparently there's another enemy right there, but I don't see them. I don't even see this yokai area on the list of things, but like I see an enemy. Very cool, when I point in there. What is with this? Are those tiny things? Do they count as enemies? What the hell? Yeah, that would have hit me while I was recovering in low stance, so it just dodged around it. Does that take extra stamina or something? I mean, it's got to, right? Jailer's keychain! There's what I was looking for a while. It was on that big guy the whole time. Maybe I can plug that thing up so it doesn't shoot me by accident again? No? Alright. Noble dung ball. Hey. Really? Noble dung ball, that's what you're going with. Okay. Let's go backwards before we go any further. And rescue that small Kodama boy from prison. I think it was... must be open from the other side. So there is still a Kodama on this floor I gotta rescue from the other side. I just gotta figure out how to get to the other side of there. This isn't the right path. That is not the right path. Must be down here. Yep, here we go. This is going to be a time. Wait, did it only aggro one of them? Because I've got super good yokai dodging on one of my accessories. Don't worry, Kodama, it's safe. You can go home. Alright, now, I guess to go to a higher floor? Whoa! Time to go to a higher floor and figure out how to drop down onto that Kodama's room? I mean, like, there's another hole here. Let me try jumping down this. I don't think I've been here yet. Wow, that hurt. No, wait, I've definitely been here. Wow, I just took 1,000 damage for nothing. Okay. Still got a prison break this second Kodama, though, and I don't know how to do it. There's something I missed? Some... It doesn't help that I cannot see jack shit in this dark freaking mansion. It's real... real spooky in here, and also real, real hard to see. Like, I'm hoping stream's even viewable, because, damn. Yeah, sorry, I'm not getting hit by that. Jailer's key should get me in here. And then whistle at this boy. Come on out. What action am I performing for you? A bow. You got it. Yeah, bye. Oh, well, that actually sucked. That wasn't a lot of stuff. Is this the explosion fall down, or just the regular fall down? Now that's the explosion fall down. Okay. Oh, I forgot about that hole. Okay, so not ideal, needless to say. Luckily, it is right here, somewhere. Yeah, it's right there. And now that all the enemies have respawned anyway, we may as well go level up. How much do I need to upgrade, and will burning my soul stones get me a second level? Nearly. Yeah, we'll start on Dex and Magic. Try to get him up to maximum. 5 extra ninja skill points for level 20. Okay. Let's get some ninja skills ready. Extra rounds, always nice. I could have increased the number of elixirs I can carry. Oh well, 10 is a good round number. I'm fine with that. Then we'll use the fire talisman and just equip them. Receive the title Devout One. Oh, I bet that's pray X or Y number of times. Oh, I can still equip fire as well. Okay, cool. Excellent. So I would need another 90,000 Amrita. How much do I have? 80,000? Yeah, I have enough. Not quite. Okay, let me also use all of my small and regular spirit stones. And now level up one more time. Magic to 15. I can upgrade my magic as well. Get some more stuff. Is there any really good stuff I want? Let's just get all the elemental talismans, why not? I still have an empty slot on there, and I'm not quite sure why. It's pretty late in the game to have an empty slot on the shrine. No, that's just two holes in the wall. That isn't the demon wall. I was thinking like, ah, finally, here's how I get that Kodama out. No. No. And a lightning weapon, so that won't break anything. Must be opened from the other side. Maybe the way to get the Kodama out of jail is on the other side of wherever I'm supposed to go next. There we go, he's overloaded. Yeah, I guess this is the way I need to keep going. So maybe once I crawl up out of the other side of that, that big one-eyed Oni's room, there will be some place I can go through to save that little Kodama. Or there's just another path I can take. Also, I can use this hot spring again, so might as well. Need to get the new Kodama a lawyer. Yeah? I can't open the door from that side. The only one that can free him is himself. Oh, this is a good sign. Plenty of treasures I could not get without the keychain that I had to get to this side of the room. Didn't want to risk there actually being an enemy who could shoot that and suddenly blow me up. Shokichi the Combustible burned to death. I mean, damn if he didn't live up to his name, though. I had to fight Shokichi the Combustible. It's just too good a name. Human the Flammable. I mean, like, yeah, that's correct. Makes sense that your name would be something like that, because it's true, but... Why did such dramatic music start up as I started going up this tower? Thank goodness I saw those graves. Death by explosion? Crushed to death. Yeah, as soon as I saw the graves, I'm like, everyone died here for a reason. Wait, this is the way to the objective. I don't want to go this way. I want to go find more Kodama. Once I go in there, there's no turning back. I can't just jump back out again. This big pillar. Then again, there's a Kodama inside the pillar. Or below it? One of the two? Yeah, he is below it. How in the world do I get to you, buddy? Anyway, let's explore the other areas of this underground zone real quick. Since I turned away from, like, two alternate paths, that maybe the... I don't want to accidentally go the right way and have to redo this entire mission. Oh, dang it, I thought I dodged that. Oh, is this prison boy? Yeah, prison break complete. Get out of here. And this is directly opposite the right way to go, so I feel pretty okay taking this path. And this looks almost like the first spider cave. Actually, look, this looks exactly like the first spider cave, which means I am back to area I am familiar with and am able to make it out of with relative ease. Two Hamaya arrows, that's nice. I needed a couple of those. Oh, now I can't go back through here without not... Wait, can I just... Oh. Yeah, I can just go through here without aggroing you. That's fine, too. Oh, hello! I remembered that attacked me a grapple at the last second and tried to dodge. Okay. And now that I've explored the other way, and I am secure in the fact that that is no longer the right way to go, I can explore and just feel like I am gonna find those Kodama regularly. I am gonna make sure there's no, like, side path leading over there, but then jump straight out of that lion's mouth into what I assume is just treasure and eventually a good boy. They already sprung their trap here, so there's no more trap to be sprung. Oh, I can totally just walk back out of this. I thought there was a drop after the, Oh. Wait. Ishida Manazumi. Unnatural death. You want to explain what that means? That's not comforting. Yeah, like, what makes the death unnatural? Like, hold on, wait. You gotta clarify, you can't just say that. Also, how do I get to that treasure? Like, is that it? That's just the room? How do I get to the treasure on that side of it? There's nowhere higher to drop from. There's an area over there, I guess. Yeah, that must be how. Gotta drop back into this room from higher up. Yeah, some revenants are just Team Ninja revenants. I'm aware, I'm just wondering what constitutes an unnatural death. That's the explosion. Wait, What, it's just a large spider? Shortcut 2. Oh, I gotta cut these down before they start spawning more boys. Dang it. Listen, buddy. Really don't need that from you right now. Yeah, Discord is brutal. Holy shit.
Damn the tsunami. A useless pawn. How could he lose? I must hurry.
Okay, so he had to abandon ship fairly recently. Kodama. Level up. To get to 20 so I can get all those missions and the things that they ultimately unlock. Okay, here we go. This is the way I hadn't taken yet. Oh no. No. That's not okay. Law Talisman. Okay. Now I can take out the other dude with Fire Wheel having been properly disposed of. There's a Kodama. Where are you? There you are. Ninja, okay. Shortcut. Unlock it. Can this one be open from this side? Yep, more shortcuts. Push it open. Huh! What? Okay, not on this floor. I was like, wait, the way I'm supposed to go? Why do I have a marker for that? It's not here. It's not right here. It's in a different area. Yeah, one sentence I started saying and then never finished was, I really appreciate with this sword setup how you get attacks that just happen so quickly that the damage text has to, like, pause for a bit. It has to catch up even after you've finished attacking. Because that's really only something I've seen with dual swords, because they're the only thing that attacked fast enough for that. Can't go that way yet. And I'm still looking for a way to save the... Hold on. Which way was out here? Oh hey, another shortcut. Yeah, that looks like end of the dungeon material. So I gotta figure out a way back to the spiral stairs where I came into this area. I honestly cannot remember which way that was, though. Down this hall. No, this had a door. Okay, if a hall doesn't have a door, that probably means I came from there. Damn it, they all have doors. Okay, they would have wanted me to rotate all the way around, right? So maybe a place like this? Yeah, here we go. This is the way I got in. What? What the fuck was that? Okay. If I drop off here and die, that sucks. But I've got to try to find a way to that small boy. So, let me cancel most of the falling damage by falling on that dude. And this is the room from earlier. Is that a rogue loading zone? I think it may have been. Oh, wait, what? There's a hole into this room from above. So how do I get there? It's like through here, basically. I can see the damn Kodama. I just don't understand how I get to him. There's nothing in here that gets me over there. There's also an area above here where I can see that I have to drop from a higher floor onto this guy. And I have no idea how to do that either. Like, there's an area right over there that I don't know how to reach. And if I go through here, that finishes the area. Like, if I go downstairs, I am convinced that's going to be the end of this level. Because this feels very boss area-ish. How irritating. It's on this floor. Like, this is the boss fight. That's it. That's all there is. So I gotta go back into the house, like the regular house, and try to figure out how to get to the Kodama from there. So it's time for some backtracking, sorry folks. I gotta go up one floor compared to that, so So I'm currently like one or two, I'm like two floors down from where I need to be to drop onto the Kodama. Or one floor down, because I gotta like go up a floor and then hook a left. And there's no pads in these side rooms that would lead me there. Maybe use a raven feather and drop from above. I don't know what you mean, but dropping onto that Kodama doesn't really do much for me. I tried dropping there. It really doesn't work. It's like I can drop into that area, yes, but I cannot drop to the Kodama. Maybe I need to blow up a wall. God, I'm hoping not, but I'll keep an eye out for any explosive barrels. No, I realize that Raven Feathers minimize fall damage. I've got that. The problem is that the fall is not the difficult part here. It's the falling into the correct place. Like, I can make that jump regularly. So I'm very far from the Kodama right now. Like, absurdly so. This way leads down there, that way leads to the exit, this way leads to spider caves. What is this, though? Is this where I need to go? No, this is just more spider caves. Maybe these aren't the same spider caves I thought they were. No, because I've been here, right? I am like 99% certain I've been here. Oh my god, I'm so slow rolling. So that's what it is. That's the big disadvantage from this. Your rolling becomes super slow. But I am pretty sure these are the same spider caves I've been to and been dropped into. Yeah, these are definitely the exact same place. Yeah, because huge piles of corpses, big room I get dropped into initially. There's a Kodama right here. I'll keep an eye out for any more explosive barrels, I guess? What's the name of this stage? Samurai from Solium. All Kodama locations for this mission. Let me just skip to the end here. Oh, there's Kodama number 8. Here, it's showing me how to get to him. Wow, this person's using a spear. That's fucking weird. Wait, what? There's just a hole in the wall there? Hold on. If I blew up something at the very beginning of all that, and therefore did not see an explosive barrel that had been there originally, I'm gonna be a bit mad at myself. But at the very least, resting at a fountain should have fixed it. So let's go check, shall we? Also, thanks for sticking with me on this, folks. It's been a heck of a time. Sorry, pardon me. Just going through here to the right place I gotta go. Don't mind me, just passing by. There was just a path in here this entire time. I couldn't see it because it was too dark. I feel really dumb. I checked that cell multiple times, I thought, too. And never saw anything. Wait, that isn't even all of the Kodama for this mission. Shit. Okay, hold on. Let me just watch the guide real quick. Okay, the one behind the wall. I found him. That's fine. Okay, see, I found Kodama number one in this video. Even the person in the video is getting hopelessly lost in this castle, and they're making a guide for it. Okay, it's in the spider pit. Kodama number three. Is the one in prison. Kodama number four. Is he also in prison? The other prison boy? No, the one that was just downstairs. Kodama number five. Wait, what? Oh, I'm dumb. That's why I couldn't find Kodama number 5. Like, he's visible from here, why can't I find him? Oh. So the reason I wasn't able to find this stuff before, at the top of this winding tower, there's a hole in the wall. I just never broke the stuff to find it. So that's how I get the medicine. And then if I descend these opposite stairs... And then I just take a quick peek around here. Kodama. And treasure chest. Okay, and that should be it. Let's go to the boss fight and get out of this hell-forsaken level. No way, it was the other way. Okay. Time for a boss fight. Ooh, yeah, that's a demon chamber. Oh, and Snake Boy. Man, are you playing up that animal motif enough, guy? That's Nobunaga, alright. On a pile of philosopher's stone.
You again. I was so close.
Don't worry, I'm sure it'll be up by the end of this. Ah, control is vibrating. He's a big boy. He's a big boy with a guardian spirit. Man, that teleportation magic is some shit, let me tell ya. Hi. Obsidian Samurai. Oh, you got axeman abilities. Oh, that is... That is something. Let me tell you. Oh, I cannot do elemental debuffs to him at all. Even lightning is just not sticking. So this is not something I'm going to be able to cheese with a chaos debuff. Time for a good old-fashioned sword fight. Oh, he's using his big spirit. What do you got? Oh wait, Obsidian Samurai is probably the one we read about. The one who was super dedicated to Nobunaga. It would explain why he's here. Water is sticking, though, weirdly enough. It's just electricity that wasn't sticking to him. Yeah, he's got water debuff now. I wonder if now lightning will stick? Oh, now he's using a sword. Oh, shit. Nope, lightning still won't stick. Okay. Oh, okay. Time for me to use my own guardian spirits. Let's go, buddy. Okay. Back far away from him and have a quick elixir. Armor of the Exceptional. Oh, you're alive. Okay, let's talk. And also, please give me your bear. Yeah, okay, cool. This is the guy we read about.
I dreamt of becoming a samurai so that I could fight for Lord Nobunaga. Who do you fight for? That spirit?
I
mean, yes, but...
I have met men who have fought, struggled, and died to create a world without war, where people and spirits can coexist in harmony. I fight for them.
But originally, yes, for the spirit. That's the reason.
Lord Nobunaga told me that he would make me a true samurai someday.
Yasuke.
He died before it could happen.
Thank you.
It seems you have achieved it on your own. Brought to this country in bondage, treated like property. But then, my Lord Nobunaga granted me the title of samurai. But I couldn't save him. Like the snake man said, I believe only my lord could rule a world as crazy as this one. But does he really want to be resurrected? An exceptional man. None can know his true feelings.
Alright, well, later. Atlas Bear. Hell yeah, that's a name. Whoa, what is that? Large soulstone. Oh shit. And highest quality cord. Guardian spirit, Genbu. Sounds familiar. I know the name of that spirit for a reason. I don't know. Anyway, let's really quickly A, level up, and B, check that new guardian spirit. Close combat damage plus 10%. Ooh. Increased damage when low on ki. Life recovery by grapple, 150. Plus 20 versus lightning. Shortened recovery time when out of ki. That's real good. Actually incredible. Requires 23 spirit, but that almost seems worth it. Also, let's go to the dojo. I can now take on a true ninja. Oh, the last ninja fight is against Okatsu. Okay. Sure. And what items do I have this time? Gallnut Broth, Poison Weapon, Poison Shuriken, Caltrop Spike Ball, Power Pill, Quick Change Scroll, survive temporarily even if your health goes down to zero. Well, that's weird. Can be buried so as to explode when either an enemy steps on it or after a set time has passed. Enemies affected by it will be rendered blind and unable to locate their target. Oh, and these have proficiency bonus. So they increase more than normal. Well, alright, fuck it. Let's give it a shot. Oh, good. We do get to hear boss music again. That's good. This is good boss music. Come on, get over here before my broth wears off. Poison. Whoa, that's a flip. Okay. Oh, she has a guardian spirit. That's right. Call my broth again. Okay, that's less okay. I keep eating power potency pills instead of... Destroyed. there we go. Mission complete. Sheath my fucked up poison sword and let's go. Genbu's one of the four great beasts. Suzaku, Genbu, Byakko, and Seiru. Okay. Cool. It's good to know. Genbu's the turtle, right? Byakko's the white tiger. Byakko was the white tiger that Nekomata got mutated into. Really? Alright. Seems weird that they wouldn't just name it that then. But... And what are the legendary ones for this? Instantly perform any you use on yourself. So that's weapon buffs, right? No, that's, absorbing... things like that. Okay. Or what's the other one? Increases damage dealt by long-range weapons or thrown items. Well, I guess we know what we're unlocking. And they give you just enough to unlock it, too. Yes. Increase my long-range damage. Thanks. So let's unlock Genbu. There's an item I left behind at the temple. Please go get it. Wouldn't be surprised if Seiryu was a guardian spirit that I already got. Maybe. Oh, it's him killing Nobunaga. Huh. Oh, shoot, that hurt. So explaining his motivations behind betraying Nobunaga, and wow, that's a lot of people. Oh shit. Oh no, not a wheel. Hate the wheel. And a Tengu, of course. Because why not? Time to apply elemental debuffs. Get discorded, motherfucker. It is what I will do to any Tengu from now on. Here we go. What? Why can I go up here? Whoa. You're a human. Wow, you deal a lot of damage too. And I have a lot of stamina. Okay. There we go. Yeah, he has a ton of health. Holy shit. Really? Oh, he used the kick too. Damn it, that's my move. Cut that shit out. A gun? Really, just a gun. Okay, we're using dogs. Forget this. Oh, yeah, that's... If he breaks my guard, I'm dead. Shit. The raccoon tail. You can't remember the person's name. Okay, so they're famous, then. Wait, I don't get to fight him again? That's a one chance thing? Man. That sucks. Or do I have to win against that guy first try? No. Damn it.
この国に収まるはずもなかった。天下に興味なぞない。わしの役目は調和を守ること。今、戸津国人が調和を乱そうとしておる。わしも再び動かねばなるまい。
Yeah, I just got Genbu. So is the mission not complete, or did I get the thing? Because it seems like that was what he was looking for. He was looking for that helmet. Yeah, mission's complete. Yeah, mission's done. Maybe you lose out on some awesome drop. Well, damn it, now I gotta try. If I know I don't get another try, though, I am using, like, talismans. Sloth talismans happening. Oh, I did. Dang it, I should have waited to. Don't know why I used two of them at the same time. I just wasn't thinking. Smithing text. Huh. Raven Tengu Taco. Taco. That's a character from a podcast I've been listening to. Spelled differently, though. Yeah, there it is. Okay, well, this is gonna suck. No death, please. Not this close to the wind. Getting a bit too close for comfort. I'm gonna get shot in the head for that, but that's okay. Okay, so it's just a little bit of extra text. You're thinking who that should be. It's the guy in the glasses himself. It's Unari? No. What was his name? I'm thinking of Ishida. He's the other guy. It's Tenkai, but Tenkai's real name. Akechi Mitsuhide. All right. I think we might actually be able to finish this tonight.